These are six original posters from 1967 by Peter Max, signed by the artist. These posters had mold spots in them. We linen-backed them and touched them up. You'll see that today on Posterfix. Hi, I'm Chris. Welcome to Posterfix Studio. Today, we're going to see more vintage posters from the 1960s, specifically by Peter Max. Take a look. When I got these posters, they were rolled together in a tube. These posters were printed in 1967.
I've actually got six of these here in this pile. They're all in about the same condition. They're all autographed by Peter Max. They all have a little bit of mold dust at the bottom. And generally, otherwise, they're in very good condition. So we're going to linen back these, but first I have to prepare a screen.
This stretcher screen has been prepared with cotton canvas. And this is the screen I'm going to use. The first thing I have to do is take acid-free paper and cover it very well all over the place with wheat paste. This wheat paste is similar to what they use in wallpaper. However, it's a finer grade, and I've added an acid buffering agent to the wheat paste. I lift the paper up and place it on the canvas, making sure that it's straight and fairly even. Then I put the screen on the table. Then taking a roller, I'm rolling over the paper to make sure the excess air pockets are pushed out of it, because I want the paper to lie very flat to the canvas and not have air pockets form later after it's dried. This will ensure that the posters lie flat onto the linen backing. This is linen backing. And there we are. The screen is ready for the posters. This poster was printed in 1967 and represents the artist's launch into psychedelic art. This poster and this kind of design, psychedelic, one could say, was very influential in other posters by other artists in the late 60s and throughout the 70s. Don't you want somebody to love? Don't you need somebody to love? Wouldn't you love somebody to love? You gotta find somebody to love. Well, it got a flow. When asked about his love poster, Peter Max said, "My love poster was my first successful 60s era poster. I was proud to have captured the zeitgeist of the 60s through my poster art and was amazed by the overwhelming reception from my hippie and flower child contemporaries and from all types of people." These posters are in very good condition and they are not glossy, and because of that fact, the paper and the inks are very stable and their condition is fairly good, except for the area of the mold where the paper is softer and more prone to break when wet.
So I have to be careful over these moldy areas because the paper is weaker.
No.
now I've got to let this poster absorb the wheat paste before I flip it over. So the paper is expanding as I put wheat paste on it. It's getting a little bit bigger. Stretches out. Now, the flip. Spraying it with water to help it expand more and absorb better. We're gonna let Peter Max glove dry for a couple days before we touch them up and trim them down. Well, one day has passed and I did another screen with the last two of these six Peter Max posters, and this one's gonna dry also. And now I've got all six Peter Max posters linen backed. And tomorrow, we're going to do the restoration. And you will see that after this commercial break. So don't go away.
Love, love, love. Love, love, love.
I love you, sweetie. That about wraps it up for today on Posterfix. And now these Peter Max posters have got a new lease on life, and we appreciate the opportunity to restore them. We also look forward to seeing your posters. Whatever you have to send us, keep them coming, because we love bringing your vintage posters back to life.